7 psychological reasons why foreign aid is harmful to Africa. Aid seems to be a good word, right? Another synonym for aid is help, and everyone thinks that Africa needs a lot of help. Of the world's population living in poverty, Africa has over 80% of that figure. It also has the highest mortality rates. Does this look like a continent that doesn't need help? Of course, Africa needs to improve. And this is the premise with which the developed world has been sending aid to Africa. Aid giving started in the 1960s and then peaked in the 1990s, and from there, there was a decline. Aid has been looked at as one of the solutions to Africa's problems. We, however, think otherwise, and in today's video, we'll be sharing with you 7 reasons why foreign aid is doing more harm than good to Africa. This is After School TV, where we inspire you to explore opportunities to achieve your life goals and make more impact. If you're new here, you're welcome. Consider subscribing to continue exploring opportunities. Also, click on the notification bell so that you'll be notified when we release new videos. 1. It increases dependency. Remember the teach me how to fish and don't give me fish analogy? Well, Africa has been receiving a lot of fish from developed countries, and as such, she hasn't learned how to fish effectively. With a lot of money coming into the pocket of some leaders from Western nations, there has been no real need for them to develop their people or their economies. The grants would always come, so why bother, some would think. Such that a lot of African countries cannot run themselves on only internally generated funds. 2. Takes away influence. Many of these aids come with clauses and conditions. Some of them could include that the countries receiving the funds would have to trade in certain commodities with the country giving the aid, even if the country would get better deals elsewhere. For example, the aid Nigeria got from China for building its rail network included that a Chinese company would have to build the rail and not a Nigerian company. Even though Nigerian companies would benefit from the experience and the payment that they would eventually receive, it might even include things such as food importation when the country's agricultural sector could use a boost, or it even already produces food. So African countries lose the initiative a lot of time due to the aid that they receive. They have to pander to the whims and caprices of whoever is giving the grant. 3. Leads to indebtedness. The word aid is a misnomer. This is because they're not always free. Even the free ones come with conditions attached to them. Aid comes in two forms, loans and grants. Loans, of course, would have to be repaid by that government or the next generation of governments. And in situations where the government can pay back within a stipulated time, sometimes they lose national assets, such as China taking over Zambia's broadcasting company. The citizens of such countries will feel powerless when a foreign entity comes to take over its national assets, and of course, the sovereignty of the nation will be at stake. 4. Breeds laziness and corruption. Take a look at the majority of African countries sitting on piles of natural resources such as oil or diamond. These countries have long depended on these natural resources, yet there hasn't been any marked improvement on the livelihood of their citizens or even their economy. The money comes freely, and those in power don't see reasons to invest in the human resources or the country since there's free money coming in. This is the same thing that sometimes happens with aids received. Not only don't they always get to the intended areas, but the government of the day can also divert them for their use. There is easy money coming in that breeds corruption, as the citizens cannot hold the government accountable for them. These monies are not taxes. They are monies from foreign entities. Therefore, the governments don't feel the need to be accountable to the people about this. There's so much cash for doing nothing that leaders are willing to fight, have civil wars just to get into that position. 5. Changes the relationship between the government and its people. Governments usually are run by taxes. Therefore, if the citizens of the countries feel dissatisfied with the government, they can change the governments or withhold their taxes until changes are made. In Africa, however, since the government might not need the citizens' money, well, they possess the power instead of the other way around. They can do as they like, and a lot of times without consequences. Aids, a lot of times, can create an imbalance of power to favor the politicians instead of the people. 6. It undermines what people need from their governments. There is a recurrent factor in countries where things work, and that's the strength of its institutions and an effective government. And these are usually homegrown as the country wrestles with its peculiar challenges and finds solutions peculiar to her people and her situations. With constant interferences from the outside, African countries might never be able to develop an effective government that would work for the people. The foreign aid coming in also makes governing a very attractive and lucrative business. Therefore, you'd not always have those who are willing to serve to get into power. You'd only have power-hungry and thieving politicians enter into public office, and since institutions have already been weakened by free, unaccounted for cash, the country will remain in a perpetual state of disrepair. 7. Is condescending and can be compared to colonialism. Let's save this dark people from themselves. That's what constant aid given communicates. It tells Africans, you can't save yourselves. You are an incompetent and an inept lot. However, Africans are doing well in the diaspora, so perhaps it doesn't mean that Africa cannot save herself. Maybe she doesn't have the will or she's dependent so much on foreign aid. Now all she can do is depend and beg. Africa was fine before the colonial masters came. They enjoyed their lives as they were, and their values were not eroded. African nations should define their priorities and work on them, rather than pandering to the politics of the developed countries. Since you're still here, here's a bonus 8, why foreign aid is doing more harm than good to Africa. 8. Used as pawn and tools in the power struggle. Some countries give aid for us and not for them. That is, these donor countries give aid, not in the interest of the receiving countries, but to further their agenda and policies. This could be to strengthen their allies and to protect their interests against other countries. A recent example is the US opposition to China's policy in Africa. The US is fighting to weaken China's power in Africa. In certain situations that they wouldn't want to give aid, knowing that China might step in would serve as a push to give such aid. Even if the receiving country doesn't deserve it, if they are sure it would be misused, it doesn't matter to them, as long as it would wane China's influence on the continent. The countries which have received the least aid in the course of the past 40 years have consistently fared better than those that are aid-dependent. One very good example is China and, of course, the Asian continent. The world also looks down on aid-dependent nations. This is evident in the way they are treated at immigrations. Until Africa learns to solve its problems, there would be no marked improvements in the continent. So, we've come to the end of today's video, and we've shown you 7 psychological reasons why foreign aid is harmful to Africa. Because we love you, our viewers, we added a bonus 8. Would like to know what you think in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, share it with your friends. Like, subscribe, and turn on your notification to continue to enjoy premium content like this. Until when next we see you, your success matters.